What's up, guys? I'm Tasha. It's been a long, long time. Bring it in. I missed you guys. Give me a hug. But I'm back. I'm ready. Let's hop right back in to the classic DIY videos. Most of you guys know my dog, Root Beer Float. Well, he turned 10 years old May 11th. I can't believe he's 10. It's just crazy how time flies when you have a little fur baby or a real baby, but I don't have one of those. So my little fur baby is 10 and I was so excited that, of course, being the mama that I am, I had to make him an edible dog cake. And I know a lot of you guys out there have dogs that you love to death too, so I thought I'd share this with you in case you guys wanted to make a cake for your dog. I know some of you guys really look forward to seeing Root Beer, so here's my little guy in all of his glory, the big 1-0, 10 years old, and he's still spunky as ever and loving, and I just woke him up from his nap. He's really tired. He's heavy. I'm out of breath, so I'm gonna let him go back to his nap. Alright, so without further ado, let's hop right into the dog DIY cake. Let's show them your cake!
Alright, so for this cake, you're going to need a quarter cup of unsweetened applesauce, 2 tablespoons of a natural peanut butter that only has peanuts as the ingredients. This is very important for your dog that it's strictly peanuts. A quarter of a cup of unsweetened pumpkin puree, 1 tablespoon of honey, and try to use an organic raw brand of honey if you can, but I didn't have any for this. Before we start all of this, you'll want to cook off a few pieces of bacon and save 1.5 tablespoons of the bacon grease. You'll need 1 egg. And last but not least, you'll need 1/2 cup of organic unbleached flour and 1/2 teaspoon of baking soda. Start off by simply mixing all of your wet ingredients together in a medium-sized bowl. Once all of your wet ingredients are thoroughly mixed together, you can fold in your dry ingredients. Now, Root Beer is only a small 20-pound dog, so he does not need a ton of cake. So I'm putting this in a 4.5-inch ramekin. If you have a larger dog or multiple dogs, or you're planning on throwing your dog a birthday party with all of his doggy friends, you can make a larger cake simply by doubling this recipe and putting it in an 8-inch cake pan. And don't worry about filling this cake mix to the top. I thought it was going to overflow in the oven, but this cake mix actually puffs up kind of like a souffle or a muffin. You'll see when it's done, but yeah, just don't worry about it. Now you're going to put your cake in a preheated 350 degrees Fahrenheit oven. Start checking your cake around 30 minutes. Just poke it with a knife and see if the middle comes out clean. And if it does, then your cake is done. While our cake is baking in the oven, this is a perfect time to make that yummy frosting for the top of your dog's cake. Of course, your dog needs frosting because any cake needs frosting. And the frosting is simply 2 more tablespoons of that all-natural peanut butter that is only peanuts, and 1/4 cup of plain Greek yogurt. And this is super simple, guys. All you have to do is mix these 2 ingredients until they're nice and smooth, and you have the perfect yummy frosting. Okay, so our cake is out of the oven now, and do you see what I mean? It looks like a muffin, the way the top just puffs up like this. But if I've learned anything from the Food Network, I know to make your cake flat and pretty, so I'm going to cut off this lumpy, uneven top of my cake. Now, of course, we are not going to waste a single bit of this cake. What you can do is put it into chunks, put it in a freezer Ziploc bag, and freeze it and thaw it out whenever your dog wants a little treat here and there. Now that the top is nice and flat, I'm also going to cut the remaining cake in half so that our dog can have a nice double-layered pretty birthday cake. And all that's left to do now is frost both of our layers and decorate our cake. Remember in the beginning, I told you to make some bacon so that we can have bacon grease for our cake? Now we can chop up our bacon and decorate the top of our cake, and your dog is gonna love this so much. Now, if you're like me and you want some aesthetically pleasing photos for the gram, you can add some candles to your cake. My dog is 10. Obviously, I put a 1 and a 0, and I actually hated these numbers. I thought they were ugly, but they were all that they had at the freaking grocery store. I feel like this doesn't need to be said, but it almost needs to be because there's always that person out there. But do not light the candles and then present this to your dog. Your dog's gonna smell the cake, lunge for it, and you don't want your dog to get burned. So please, please do not do this. Only do this for photos, not around your dog. I was super pleased with the way that this cake came out. I think it looks so good. And the most important part, Root Beer loved it. He devoured this thing like there was no tomorrow. So I think your dog will enjoy it. It's Root Beer approved, and I hope you guys try it out. So as you can see, that was super easy, and I guarantee your dog is going to love this and eat it up like there's no tomorrow. Let me know in the comments down below if you've ever made your dog a birthday cake or edible ice cream for your dog, or if you had a birthday party for your dog, let me know, because I think that's really cool, actually. Also, let me know in the comments if you are a part of the notification squad, if you clicked that bell by the subscribe button, that way you get notified of all of my videos, and if you are, I will shout you out in my next video. Okay, so I really hope all of my dog lovers out there enjoyed this video, and I will see you guys in my next one. I love you guys so much. Bye, guys. I'm back.